Hi, I'm Janice, and I welcome you all again on our Family Light today. We have Dr. Ashutosh Shukla with us, who is the head director and head of internal medicine at Artemis Hospital. Welcome, sir.
थैंक यू।
लेटली हमें बहुत क्वेरीज आ रही थी व्हाट्सएप पर, क्योंकि सर के साथ हमारा एक स्वाइन फ्लू पे शो भी रन हो रहा है, तो इसकी वजह से ही या बिकॉज स्वाइन फ्लू के केसेस बहुत तभी बढ़ चुके हैं दिल्ली एनसीआर में स्पेशली, इस वजह से हमारे को काफी क्वेरीज आई हैं। तो हमने डिसाइड किया कि हम एक फैमिली लाइव करते हैं डॉक्टर के साथ ऑन स्वाइन फ्लू। सो स्टार्ट करते हैं, तो मैं एक पर्सनल क्वेश्चन पूछना चाहूंगी स्टार्टिंग में कि स्वाइन फ्लू जो है एक्चुअली क्या होता है।
स्वाइन फ्लू इज अ डिजीज व्हिच इज अ हाईली कंटेजियस डिजीज इन्वॉल्विंग द रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक्ट, मीनिंग इट्स बड़ी जल्दी एक से दूसरे को फैलती है एंड इन्वॉल्व्स द अपर एयरवेज एंड द लंग्स एंड इट इज कॉज्ड बाय अ वायरस व्हिच इज ऑफ द इन्फ्लुएंजा कैटेगरी ऑफ वायरस एंड एज यू नो इन्फ्लुएंजा वायरस can cause various kind of diseases. So there are three categories in influenza virus, A, B and C. And you must have heard of seasonal flu, you must have heard of avian flu, now H1N1, all these are category A influenza viruses. So these are very highly contagious viruses, but the unique thing about this particular virus is that it changes its shape every year, which is known as antigenic drift. So the surface shows a different character every year and hence we get these outbreaks or epidemics. And every 20 years, there's an antigenic shift, means the structure of the virus changes, mutates. So every 20 years, there's a pandemic, approximately 20 years, which pandemic means that the disease spreads across continents from one person to another, involving multiple countries.
Okay, so ye jo virus hai, ye animals mein bhi dekha jata hai, but human based.
What happened was that in 2009, when initially this virus was detected, it was first detected in humans, those people who were handling pigs, because the virus spread from pigs to humans in 2009. So that's when the scientists named it swine flu. But ever since, the spread has been from humans to humans. So unfortunately, the name got stuck on and it's known as swine flu. Swine flu presents with high grade fever, usually 100 degree Fahrenheit or above. It has the patient has a lot of body ache, cough, sore throat, runny nose, stuffy nose, intense body aches, muscle pains, may have diarrhea, vomiting. So it is quite similar to common khasi jukham or seasonal flu. But the difference is that the onset, the way the symptoms start in swine flu, it will be sudden onset.
Achha.
Whereas in seasonal flu, it will be a very gradual, slow onset. Like stuffy nose and sore throat is more common in common cold. But in swine flu, it is less common. Intensity and lethargy and the pain is much more in swine flu, less in common cold. So these are very subtle differences and it is best for your doctor to decide the difference. And if the symptoms are persisting, they're lingering, you should consult your physician.
So aisa hota hai ki pehle kabhi jaise humko cold hua ya fever hua uske baad joint pain ya diarrhea vagaira start hua ya ye mix starting se hi ho jate hain ye hamare symptoms?
So usually it starts with intense body aches, fever, cough, साथ में ही डायरिया या वॉमिटिंग भी होता है।
अच्छा, तो ये एक ही साथ में सब सिम्टम्स दिखने लगते हैं।
या यूजुअली।
ओके। अच्छा, उसके बाद सिम्टम्स तो चलो हो गए, ठीक है। नेक्स्ट ये है कि कौन सा एज ग्रुप है ऐसा जो जिसमें ये ज्यादा होने के चांसेस हैं?
सो देयर आर सर्टेन कैटेगरी ऑफ पीपल हु आर मोर एट रिस्क ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्टिंग स्वाइन फ्लू एंड इन these category of people, the complication rates are much higher, like people above 65 years of age, children less than 5 years of age, women in the family way, people who are morbidly obese with a BMI above 40, or people who already have a coexisting medical illness like heart disease, diabetes, chronic bronchitis, asthma, or people whose immune system is suppressed, like who are on steroids, or they have a cancer which is suppressing the immune system. So these are the category of people who are at high risk of catching swine flu, plus complication rates are much higher in
आई
these
थिंक
categories.
इम्यूनिटी का इसमें
Yes,
एक है ना.
it depends upon the patient's immune status as well as it depends upon the amount of viral load which has entered the body.
अच्छा एक क्वेश्चन है हमारे को जो आया है, हाउ डू आई प्रोटेक्ट माई सेल्फ फ्रॉम कैचिंग H1N1 एंड रिड्यूसिंग द स्प्रेड ऑफ द वायरस.
So, to understand how you want to protect yourself, first and foremost, you must understand how the disease spreads. So, once you understand the basics of how the disease spreads, then it is very easy for you to take the steps to prevent the illness. So, the disease spreads by droplets. I mean, when a person is having cough or sneezing, so when you are coughing or sneezing, the tiny water droplets which come out, when you cough and sneeze, these droplets have viruses to the extent that each droplet may have 1 lakh to a crore virus particles in it. And when these particles move around in the air around you, so there are two ways in which the virus can spread from one person to another. One is a direct contact, mean within a 3 feet radius, means arm length radius, from a person who's coughing, sneezing, the virus can come to a healthy person directly. The other way is indirect spread. That means when these coughlet droplets fall on hard surfaces like the keyboard or the door handle or the telephone handset, these droplets contain the virus and the virus survives on these hard surfaces for at the most 2 hours. And if a healthy person comes and touches the same surface with his fingers, the virus comes onto his fingers. And then when he rubs his eyes or touches his nose or mouth, that's how the virus enters your body. So the simple technique of preventing is, first, when a person is having coughing or sneezing, he should cough or sneeze into a tissue paper and discard the tissue every time you cough and sneeze. And wash your hands frequently with running tap water and soap. I mean, it should be a thorough rinsing with at least 20 seconds spent on washing your hands. And if you don't have access to running tap water and soap, even hand sanitizers are good, but not as good as running water and soap. Then avoid touching the T zone of the face. T zone meaning the eyes, nose, and mouth. So that's how the virus enters your body. And plus, of course, keeping your immune system strong. And how you keep your immune system strong is by having a healthy, nutritious diet, making sure that you don't skip meals. Having an adequate 7 8 hours of sleep and exercising regularly. So these are things which will keep your immune system strong.
That is a healthy lifestyle.
So that will help your strong immune system and you can prevent these viruses.
Okay. So next question we have is swine flu dangerous?
Yes, swine flu is potentially dangerous. If you treat it in time, it is fully treatable condition. Within 2 3 days, if you start the specific antiviral drugs, it is 100% treatable. But if you miss this window of opportunity and if the infection travels, it can cause pneumonia, it can cause ARDS, adult respiratory distress syndrome, and it can also cause myocarditis, means heart involvement, as a complication of swine flu. And patients land up in ICU, and swine flu patients who come to the ICU, the mortality is roughly 92-95%.
So, is it like possible that once you have swine flu वो हो गया ठीक, दोबारा आप swine flu आपने वो infection catch कर लिया, is it
Yes,
possible?
this is very much possible because the virus mutates. Like I said in the beginning, the surface of the virus changes its character and shape. So you can get a second episode of swine flu if you had one episode in the past.
Okay. So we have another question. How long does the swine flu germ live on the surface, like on my desk if someone sneezes in my office?
So the droplets which contain the virus, when these droplets fall on hard surfaces, the virus survives in these droplets on hard surfaces for 2 hours.
Two hours.
So within these 2 hours, if a healthy person touches this heart, same heart surface mm-hmm. where the viruses are there, mm-hmm. he can catch infection from there.
Okay. Okay, so I have a list of questions that I got from WhatsApp. So I'll ask some of those also.
Sure.
How do I protect myself from catching H1N1 and reducing the spread of the virus? That is what we had answered already.
Right.
Like some tips that you want to share, apart from like washing hands or staying away from infected person.
Yeah, so one should avoid crowded places. And if there is somebody who's coughing and sneezing, stay away from him. And keep an arm's distance at least. Wearing masks and all, I mean, a simple mask is advisable if you are in crowded places. But the N95 mask is not advisable for routine use. That N95 mask is to be worn only if you are handling specimens of H1N1 for healthcare workers, or if you are doing certain procedures on patients, like if you are doing a tracheal suction or if you are doing a bronchoscopy for healthcare workers, it's mainly meant. But a routine surgical mask is good enough to protect you.
Acha. So someone asked, should I wear a face mask or respirator? If not, what? Why are face masks not recommended?
So a face mask is recommended. But only a simple surgical face mask, only in those conditions where you feel the potential threat of a virus, not routinely. If you are in a crowded place, if you feel somebody is coughing, sneezing near you, yes, there it is. But do not use a respirator as a routine prevention. It doesn't make sense.
So current seasonal influenza से बचाने के बचने के लिए कुछ टिप्स तो हम
keep your immune system strong, get adequate hours of sleep, have a nutritious balanced diet, exercise regularly, and take adequate amounts of fluids in the day, and avoid skipping meals. So that will keep your immune system strong. Plus, wash your hands frequently with soap and water. Avoid touching the T-zone or the face. And if you are coughing, sneezing, stay home, recover, and then go back to work. And when you are coughing and sneezing, use a tissue paper to cough and sneeze and discard the tissue into a dustbin.
Okay, so exercise, diet, or hygiene. I think these three most important.
That's right.
Right? To fight not only swine flu, but koi bhi influenza.
Not only influenza, but other infections also, like which are spread by droplet, like chickenpox, measles, mumps, rubella, even tuberculosis, bacterial meningitis for that matter. So any disease which is spread by droplets can be prevented by these simple measures. So a dangerous illness like swine flu or tuberculosis can be prevented by simple steps, provided you are aware of it.
So we have another question. Can it be transmitted from animals to humans?
It potentially is a disease of animals. It started from pigs, but nowadays it is spreading from humans to humans only.
So my dog can get this virus in?
Well, it's a mammal. Yes, it can get
it. It can get
it. All mammals can get infection.
And in case of humans, if I have like a little throat pain or something, if I take antivirals, will they be effective in the like in the initial stage?
So antivirals are not indicated as a routine. One should avoid jumping to antiviral tablets right in the beginning. Let your doctor or physician decide whether you really need antiviral tablets.
Okay.
Because he is the best judge.
Yes.
So you should try simpler things in the beginning, maybe do some gargles, take hot water, hot soups, take rest, hydrate yourself really well with coconut water, have a cocoa drink or hot tea with honey, simple things. And then if the symptoms worsen, then maybe consult your physician.
So basically, apne doctor khud nahi banna, doctor ko dikha do to acha hai. Acha, another question we have, agar kisi ko HIV or AIDS होते हैं और उसको इन्फ्लुएंजा हो जाए H1N1 का, आर दे मोर लाइकली टू सफर कॉम्प्लिकेशंस?
यस, डेफिनेटली. अ पेशेंट हु हैज HIV who gets H1N1, the complication rates are far higher. The complications like pneumonia, bronchitis, myocarditis, adult respiratory distress syndrome, ARDS, all these are more common in people who are already immune compromised. That's why these people should be vaccinated necessarily.
So swine flu ka bhi kuch vaccine hai,
vaccination yes.
Hai
kya? Yes, yes, definitely we have a vaccine which is available, and one should make sure that you take the right vaccine every year, because every year the strain of the virus changes, and the vaccine should be administered around September, October, because there's a new vaccine which is available in the market. So make sure that you take the prevalent strain vaccine, not the last year's vaccine. So that you are protected for that particular strain of that virus which is prevailing in that season.
How long does it take to recover from swine flu?
So it depends upon whether if you take antiviral drugs within 3 days of onset of a swine flu, the recovery is very fast. Within 24 to 48 hours, you start having signs of recovery. But if you miss that opportunity, if you don't treat it in time, then it can prolong, it can cause a lot of serious complications.
How long after exposure to swine flu do symptoms appear?
So this is known as the incubation period, what you are talking about. An incubation period is when the virus enters a person's body and the onset of symptoms. This is usually about 4 to 5 days.
Can I catch it from eating pork meat and pork products?
It does not spread from pork and pork products or chicken. It spreads by droplets from a person who already has swine flu. But yes, the precaution is if you are eating, you can definitely eat pork and chicken, but it should be well cooked pork and well cooked chicken. And in this season particularly, avoid uncooked or partially cooked meat, and avoid mayonnaise which has raw egg.
So raw food,
raw eggs avoid karne chahiye,
but raw meat, raw eggs kuch bhi hai, usko avoid karna chahiye.
But if you are having properly well cooked meat and well cooked egg, please go ahead.
Maine bhi recently ek case suna tha jisme mere known mein koi pregnant lady thi, unko swine flu ho gaya tha. So kitna kya matlab kya reason hai aur क्या करना चाहिए अगर कोई प्रेग्नेंट है?
सो प्रेग्नेंट लेडीज आर मोर एट रिस्क ऑफ कैचिंग स्वाइन फ्लू बिकॉज इट्स प्रेगनेंसी इज अ इम्यून मॉड्यूलेटेड स्टेट इन द सेंस द इम्यून सिस्टम इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम अ नॉर्मल हेल्दी एडल्ट सो दे आर मोर एट रिस्क ऑफ हैविंग इन्फेक्शंस प्लस द अदर प्रॉब्लम इज दैट वंस अ पर्सन हूज इन द फैमिली वे गेट्स स्वाइन फ्लू बिकॉज ऑफ रिपीटेड कॉफिंग कैन गेट abortions, missed abortion, or threatened abortion. So these are potential complications. The swine flu virus doesn't spread directly through the placenta, but yes, it can cause complications in the mother.
Can swine flu go away on its own?
It is a viral illness. If the viral load is not so large and if the immune system is strong, it can be limited, but it can spread very rapidly also.
So can antibacterial medicines
antibiotics
help in fighting swine flu?
No, there is no role for antibiotics in swine flu. But yes, there after some stage in patients with swine flu, there may be some secondary bacterial infection. At that stage, the patient does require antibiotics, but that is for the treating doctor to decide.
मुझे कैसे पता चलेगा कि मुझे कुछ लक्षण हैं तो मुझे swine flu है? So he is talking about symptoms.
Right. So swine flu symptoms are usually similar to a seasonal flu, khansi zukham, but intensity and onset is more severe. It starts suddenly in a and rapidly progresses. So the onset is very fast in swine flu. The intensity of the body aches are much more in swine flu, and they are lesser in a seasonal flu.
Okay, so another pregnant lady se hi mujhe yaad aaya. So if you have swine flu, you are diagnosed with swine flu, so can you breastfeed your baby after like giving birth?
Yeah, so for lactating mothers, if a mother gets swine flu, definitely she can breastfeed the child, because the virus does not travel through lactation. It and the antiviral drugs don't travel through milk. But yes, direct contact can spread the virus to the baby. So when you are coughing, sneezing, have a tissue paper, within a 3 feet radius, the direct spread can happen.
Okay, that is so, for the women who are pregnant, so swine flu ki jo bhi medications hoti hain, to wo unko kahin andar effect karti hai, kuch
complications? No, the swine flu medications are absolutely safe for pregnant women. There's no problem.
No problem. Okay, and what about people above the age of 65 years? Unko unka kya complications ho sakte hain? Unko kya problem ho sakti hai?
So people above 65 years of age, there the rate of complications is much higher. So they should first of all be protected by yearly vaccine to protect from swine flu, the typical prevalent strain of that virus, in September, October, once a year. And they are more prone to landing with complications. Once you take the vaccine, the protection starts within 2 weeks' time, and it lasts. The protection lasts for a year, so the vaccine has to be repeated every year.
अच्छा, तो बच्चों में भी क्या कुछ symptoms अलग देखे जाते हैं या
small children the symptoms of swine flu are irritability, their lack of feeding, chidchidapan, excessive crying. So these are symptoms which.
तो बच्चों के केस में ऐसे कुछ प्रिकॉशंस, क्योंकि बच्चे तो सुनते नहीं हैं, हम ऐसा क्या कर सकते हैं कि वो उनको हम फॉलो करवा सकें, कुछ चीज जिसकी वजह से वो हम उनको प्रोटेक्ट कर सकें?
या सो इफ अ चाइल्ड हैज अ गुड स्ट्रांग इम्यून सिस्टम, ही इज प्रोटेक्टेड फ्रॉम स्वाइन फ्लू. चिल्ड्रन लेस देन 5 इयर्स आर मोर प्रोन टू कैचिंग स्वाइन फ्लू, सो दे शुड बी वैक्सीनेटेड. एंड healthy nutritious diet helps building the strong immune system, so that is also helpful in protecting yourself.
So babies who are under the age of 1, can they also take antivirals?
So yes, there are syrups available which are according to the body weight, which a pediatrician is best to advise.
Okay, so we have another question. As swine flu is spreading, do we need to get swine flu vaccination? And if yes, from where we can get it? Next question.
So, yes, the vaccine should be administered. The protection of the vaccine comes only after 2 weeks of taking the shot. And it lasts for a year. And it is a very safe vaccine. It should not be administered during an active illness. Agar aapko koi jukham, khansi hai, ya bukhar bhi hai, तो उन दिनों आपको वैक्सीन नहीं लेना है. एंड डेफिनेटली इट इज स्ट्रॉन्गली इंडिकेटेड इन पीपल अबव 65 इयर्स ऑफ एज, चिल्ड्रन लेस देन 5 इयर्स ऑफ एज, पीपल हु हैव अ क्रॉनिक मेडिकल कंडीशन लाइक डायबिटीज, हार्ट डिजीज, और लंग कंडीशंस लाइक एस्थमा, ब्रोंकाइटिस, और हु आर मॉर्बिडली ओबीस, देयर डेफिनेटली देयर शुड बी गिवन द स्वाइन फ्लू वैक्सीन.
अच्छा, so what food or diet do you recommend to
for people who have infection?
Yeah, who infection and after the treatment also.
So it should be a nutritious diet. Hydration is critically important. So hot soups, coconut water, fresh lime, cocoa based drinks, hot tea with honey. So these are various ways by which you can hydrate yourself really well, and having a good nutritious diet, which helps build your immune system, and taking adequate rest. ड्यूरिंग द इलनेस।
ओके, सो जो ये स्वाइन फ्लू है ये क्या विंटर सीजन में ज्यादा देखा जाता है या समर्स में भी इसके केसेस?
सो यूजुअली इट हैपेंस अराउंड आफ्टर सितंबर अक्टूबर, यूजुअली विद चेंज ऑफ वेदर, एंड दीज एपिडेमिक्स हैपन रैंडमली डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द एंटीजेनिक ड्रिफ्ट एंड शिफ्ट व्हिच आई वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट। सो लाइक दीज डेज वी आर हैविंग अ सडन आउटब्रेक ऑफ स्वाइन फ्लू अक्रॉस द कंट्री।
सो आपके इसमें कुछ ऐसा आपने अभी सुना अपने केसेस में, आप यू हैंडल सो मेनी पीपल, कि स्वाइन फ्लू से वो ठीक हुए हैं एंड देन सडनली बिकॉज ऑफ द इम्यूनिटी लो होती है कुछ और इन्फेक्शन कैच करा है उन्होंने या कुछ?
सो इफ अ पर्सन गेट्स स्वाइन फ्लू एंड इफ यू ट्रीट हिम इन टाइम द रिकवरी इज वेरी गुड एंड वेरी फास्ट, बट इफ द स्पेसिफिक एंटीवायरल ड्रग्स आर नॉट एडमिनिस्टर्ड इन टाइम विद इन 3 डेज देन ऑब्वियसली हिज इम्यून सिस्टम गेट्स broken and he invites various complications and the illness gets prolonged.
Okay. Another is I have diabetes. What are the complications if I face swine flu? Does the treatment remain the same?
So people who have diabetes, they should make sure that their sugar controls are appropriate because uncontrolled sugars invite infections and once they get infection, then with high sugars, controlling the infection becomes a problem. So diabetic patients should be protected in advance with a swine flu vaccine, which should be administered once a year. And sugar controls are critically important through the illness.
Okay, so are there any tests available for H1N1?
Yes, of course. A physician diagnoses on a clinical basis your symptoms and signs that potentially you may be having swine flu. So what he does is he orders a test known as a nasopharyngeal throat swab. So what they do is that they take a sterile swab and they touch the back of the throat and the nose, and then this swab is sent to the laboratory where genetic based testing is done on this swab, and by the PCR method they detect the virus. So if this is the only confirmatory test, there are other methods as well. In the blood sample you can do a BioFire test, which will pick up other viruses as well, but standard testing is through this nasopharyngeal throat swab.
Another question is, how serious is the new influenza?
Flu H1N1 swine flu can be potentially serious in the sense if it is not treated in time, it can cause complications like pneumonia, it can cause adult respiratory distress syndrome, it can cause myocarditis, lung involvement, heart inflammation, myocarditis, and patients do land up in ICU. H1N1 with complications in an ICU has very high mortality.
Okay, next we have, is there a home remedy to swine flu?
Home remedy, yes, in the sense hydration, rest, fluids and all. But since there is a very specific antiviral drug available, one should first diagnose the condition by a proper test, and if the swine flu is detected on the throat swab, he should take the specific antiviral drug.
Okay, and we were talking about the tests. So are these tests expensive?
So these throat swab tests are expensive, and the government has set a certain amount of capping on the amount which a laboratory can charge. So the by the Government of India, it has been set as an upper limit of 4,500 for a throat swab test, but various labs have different rates.
Okay, next we have, what can we do to prevent swine flu in small children?
Okay, so in small children, like I said, having a strong immune system, by having a nutritious diet, making sure their hygiene standards are good, making sure that they take the, if for children less than 5 years, once a year swine flu vaccine. So these are the ways how you can prevent swine flu in children.
सो आप हमारे ऑडियंस को, जो हमारे व्यूअर्स हैं, आप उन्हें क्या एडवाइस करेंगे स्वाइन फ्लू के बारे में?
सो स्वाइन फ्लू इज अ कंडीशन विच कैन बी पोटेंशियली वेरी डेंजरस, बट द प्रिवेंटिव स्टेप्स आर सिंपल एंड वेरी बेसिक. सो इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड द इलनेस, हाउ इट स्प्रेड्स, वॉट दिस डिजीज इज, यू कैन ईजिली प्रिवेंट अ मेजर कॉम्प्लिकेशन एंड यू कैन लीड अ हेल्दी लाइफ एंड यू कैन अवॉइड दीज इन्फेक्शंस.
ओके, वी हैव अनदर क्वेश्चन. हाउ इज स्वाइन फ्लू डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द नॉर्मल फ्लू और इन्फ्लुएंजा इन टर्म्स ऑफ सिम्टम्स?
सो स्वाइन फ्लू द ऑनसेट ऑफ डिजीज इज वेरी सडन एंड वेरी रैपिड. इन द नॉर्मल फ्लू, द कॉमन कोल्ड एंड सीजनल फ्लू, देयर द ऑनसेट विल बी स्लो. इन स्वाइन फ्लू द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ द फीवर इज मच हायर देन 100. इन कॉमन कोल्ड यूजली द टेम्परेचर्स आर लेस देन 100. इन स्वाइन फ्लू द चांसेस ऑफ हैविंग कॉम्प्लिकेशंस आर फार मोर, लाइक निमोनिया, ब्रोंकाइटिस एटसेट्रा. वेर इज इन कॉमन कोल्ड, सीजनल फ्लू, यू नेवर गेट कॉम्प्लिकेशंस. सोर थ्रोट, स्टफी नोज इज मोर कॉमन in common cold, less common in swine flu.
Okay. I travel for work. Should I keep a face mask on?
Yes, a normal surgical face mask is advisable if you are traveling in crowded places. It definitely helps. Along with it, washing your hands with soap and water frequently. So these are good practices.
Okay. Another question is swine flu more of a developing country problem?
No, it's prevalent across the world, even in developed nations. It has seen nothing to do with the economic strata of the society.
Okay. Another, the same person is asking, is it safe to travel without face mask?
Well, it's always advisable to take precautions. If you are in crowded places, somebody is coughing, sneezing, a face mask will definitely protect you.
Okay. Okay, thanks.
So is that it?
I think we are done for today. A lot, many queries, I think, is going to come afterwards also.
Right.
Because swine flu is on the rise right now. Thank you, doctor, so much for joining us today.
Thank you, Janice. Thank you for inviting me.
And thank you, everybody who has joined us. We'll get back with a new... Actually, aap log bataiye, aapko kis topic par humse baat karni hai? Aap bataiye, hum lekar aayenge aapko. आपके सामने किसी नए स्पेशलिस्ट को. हमारा व्हाट्सएप नंबर है 8527940940. उस पर आप हमें व्हाट्सएप कर सकते हैं, आप अपना एडवाइस कर सकते हैं, आप किस बारे में चाहेंगे हम दोबारा फैमिली लाइव करें. टिल देन टेक केयर, सी यू सून.